Honey, why didn't you tell us you were coming home? Hey, everything all right?
Yeah, Daddy, everything's fine.
I thought you could stay at Big Sur a lot longer. Well, I wanted to call you up every day, see how things are going, but I knew you wanted to be by yourself.
Yeah, I did.
You look wonderful.
Well, thank you. I feel a lot better. I spend almost every day climbing down to the beach and going for a walk along the ocean. Daddy, I finally feel like I had a chance to think everything through.
Mm-hmm.
And I've reached a very important decision.
TJ? TJ?
What?
Come here, I want to talk to you.
Yeah, all right, so talk.
Kelly's coming back today, you know that?
Well, gee, that's real nice. Nice short trip she had, huh?
Yeah. That's because she doesn't know what could happen to her here.
Let me tell you something. I appreciate you bringing me the good news. So when she gets back into town, you and me are going to...
No, we are not going to do anything. This thing has gotten far, way far out of hand already.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'll tell you what I'm talking about. Nothing is going to happen to Kelly, okay? Because I'm not going to let it. I'm going to make sure of that. In fact, I'm telling her the truth now, today.
I don't think so, partner. I don't think so.
Mason? Oh.
Something wrong?
No, it's just me. Jumpy, I was afraid you disappeared again.
Just to the grocery store. There was nothing to eat for breakfast.
I'm sorry. I know how tired you are. You were really exhausted last night.
Yeah, I really was.
I fell asleep while I was kissing you.
No kidding.
It was insulting. But you look so sweet, I don't want to wake you.
Sorry, it must have been those pills the doctor gave me for my toe. They worked. It's much better today.
And you look better. Bet you look very handsome.
Well, wait till I have my breakfast. Then I'll really be energized.
Energized? She was sleeping 2 minutes ago.
Oh, damn.
I'll go change your diaper or something. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Hello?
Jane, it's Sonny. There's no way I'm gonna pull this off. This girl's all over me like a cheap suit.
Look, just calm down, Sonny.
I'll calm down when you get me out of here.
She's okay. What were you doing?
Oh, I was just getting ready to whoop us up a great breakfast. I'm starving. How about you?
Whoop?
Yeah, well, as far as I'm concerned, we can start the interrogation the minute I get there. What? I'll be leaving in a few minutes. You know, Boswell, it occurs to me... If this kid shows the same kind of remorse he seemed to be showing in the television studio, the court is likely to go very easy on him. A few minutes. Yeah. What's wrong?
Nothing. Just thinking about what I have to do today.
Going down to the station, right?
Yeah, I have a telecast at noon. Nothing special.
Yeah, well, we can't expect to make headlines every time we go on the air.
Don't want to either. In fact, I wish it didn't happen.
Yeah, me too. You know, I think you may have helped that kid out more than you know. Well, I guess I'll be off to the courthouse. I'll see you later.
Okay.
You be careful.
Am I doing something wrong?
You're eating grits.
Well, yeah. You should try some. They're very nutritious.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what you're missing. Put a little butter, salt and pepper, splash of gravy.
Gravy?
What's wrong with gravy?
Wherever you've been, it's certainly changed your eating habits.
Yeah, I guess so.
I hope it hasn't changed anything else about...
Like what?
Well, about how you feel about me and Samantha.
Well, no, of course not. You're, aware of the depth of my feeling for the two of you.
Honey?
Hmm?
You know, it meant a lot to me that the first thing you wanted to do when you got back was set the wedding date.
Yeah. About that date, are you sure that it gives you enough time to plan the wedding? I wouldn't want to rush an event as blessed as that one.
Well, I know it'll be rushed, but that's the day that you wanted it to be, and if that's what you want, then that's what I want.
Good. I just want to make sure it's not too much for you.
Hopefully it'll be my first and only wedding, and I want it to be perfect.
Good. Well, I better hit the showers.
No.
No?
No, I know how much you like your baths, and I'll just go run some water for you.
Whoa, you don't have to do that.
No, I want to. You've been away for a long time, and I just want to make you happy, so just let me enjoy that, okay? Hello?
It's me again.
Sonny, you cannot keep calling me.
I won't have to.
No, you're not going to blow this deal for me.
This lady's already planning her march down the aisle. I don't even know her.
You get to know her.
Well, you know, I'm not sure what she's got in mind. She's hot
to trot.
But what?
Well, this one's just not my type.
Look, what did you do last night?
Well, I pretended to fall asleep. I blamed it on those pills the doctor gave me.
Oh, that's clever.
Now she wants me to take a bath.
Well, take a bath.
I think she wants to watch me take it.
So she'll get in the tub with you. You'll probably have a good time. Just go with it.
In the bathtub? I got to talk to you, Gina. I'm coming over.
You cannot come over here. We're not supposed to see each other. I told you, it's just too risky.
I'm walking out right now.
No, look, all right. I'll come over to your office. Now, I gave you the address. You know where it is, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, time. I was calling the time.
Hmm. You didn't have to worry about the time today.
Well, I know that, but...
Do you, want to take a bath?
Seems the dude you fingered for us has mysteriously disappeared.
Somebody must have tipped him off.
Well, that's pretty convenient, wouldn't you say?
Look, Detective Castillo,
Not anymore.
What?
Skip it.
Look, I know you hate me. I'd hate myself, too, after what I put your wife through. But I don't know what else to say right now. Except that day I lost it, I'm sorry.
And what's to stop you from losing it tomorrow and blowing somebody away on the street?
I wouldn't do that, man.
Oh, you wouldn't do that? You held a gun to my wife's head, man. You want to see the videotape?
I thought she turned on me. Don't you understand? She came to me and said she cared. I trusted her. No one ever cared before, you know? And then when I thought she turned to me in, I don't know what happened, man. I just went nuts. I had to strike back, but I swear I would have never hurt her.
Why should we believe that? You got a history of hurting people.
Not a single one of those charges stuck, man. Because they were hype. I know I've been in my share of trouble, but I was just trying to survive. You tried living on the street since you were 10, man. No home, no family. In all those years, no one's ever treated me decent until your wife. And now I know she meant what she said, because she really is gonna help me. But you guys put me away. You know what's gonna happen to a kid like me. I won't stand the chance. And if I ever get out alive, there's gonna be no one there to help me.
Cruz.
With that story and what's on the tape, 100-1, he'll cop a suspended sentence. Probation. I'm not sure there's any point in wasting the court's time or the taxpayers' money.
I don't know. There's something to... Gritter, what is the last thing you said to my wife before those cops took you out of that place?
I don't know, man. There was so much confusion, I don't remember.
So what are you thinking?
Drop the charges.
It's your call.
All this is the response for one show?
Well, the man did hold you at gunpoint, dear. And then it went out on every network and local news within the next 24 hours.
We've had to put on extra operators to handle the phone calls for the last 3 days.
I can't believe it.
Believe it. With one brilliant interview, you've made yourself an instant celebrity.
Well, you know what Andy Warhol said.
I think you're going to last a lot longer than 90 seconds, right, Lydia?
Mm-hmm. Especially with the follow-up we're going to have you do.
What follow-up?
I thought we'd try to get a couple of Critter's fellow gang members in here, or maybe we'll go on location. I've also lined up a therapist. I want you to interview him about the psychology of crisis situations.
Oh, I can't do that.
Of course you can. That's going to be great. Look, the ratings are going through the roof.
No, it's a lie. He came on here. Everything he did was an act. He as much told me so himself. I told Lydia.
I know.
You know?
Yeah, Lydia told me. But it doesn't change a damn thing because they don't know.
Well, they're going to know because I'm going to tell them. I'm not going to take credit for something that didn't happen.
It happened. Look, for that 1 minute, for those people out there, you did something nothing short of miraculous, and you are not going to take that away from them. Look, come on, you're at the beginning of what could be a great career. Just relax.
I can't do it.
I don't think you get the picture, Eden. You don't have a choice. Now, you either keep quiet about this, or you're gone. And you never work in this business again.
I'm not gonna put up with this anymore, you hear me?
I don't think you should. Kelly's gotten away with enough, all right? Maybe it's time we stopped her. For good.
Not bad, huh? Maybe you can keep one of those as a souvenir, you know? Because I'll tell you something. I got a bunch of these stuck away in a very private place, in case you get the right idea.
You bastard.
That's me. But you gave it all up with no resistance, pal. I'm very impressed. All the stuff about Kelly's insurance policy, the millions you can get from it, and also that little accidental death clause.
That doesn't mean a damn thing. I did nothing, you hear me?
Not yet, but you will.
Oh? Really, will I?
Yeah. In case you don't know, the conspiracy to murder is a crime here. Maybe you haven't been in this country long enough. How about another thing? Might open up a few questions about that accidental death of your first wife, right?
That's right. You got it. You got the word accidental.
Maybe you didn't listen to this tape. Bub, you talk like a man of experience. You got that? We're into this thing up to our necks. So let me give you a little advice. If Kelly stops by here, you keep your mouth shut. You got it?
Yesterday wasn't you. We both need some time. I've gone to San Diego to think things through. I still love you, Kane. If you need to reach me,
Yeah, Eden Castillo, please. Oh, yeah, that's right. She told me she's going to be on here at noon. Just tell her, her husband called, and I'll call back. Yeah.
You can have a seat, Major Hamilton. I'll be with you in just a moment.
Thank you.
His release forms need to be signed.
All right, I'll take that.
I want to thank you, Mr. Castillo, for everything.
Just keep your nose clean.
I will, I swear. I know where I went wrong. Look, I hope you tell your missus that I'll never forget her. Ever.
All right, let's go. I'll be back shortly, Major, so you can sign that complaint.
Well, now, I hope the complaint he just mentioned isn't against Kane.
You know it is. The man tried to kill me.
No, he didn't. He just beat the living hell out of you, which he had every reason to do.
I don't have to put up with this.
Philip, you signed that complaint. I will personally see to it that the press is informed of certain heretofore unknown highlights of your military career.
My military career is a matter of record.
No. People don't know. People don't know how you made certain ludicrously stupid decisions in the line of fire that cost dozens of young recruits their lives. How you coerced an innocent girl into, one, passing herself off as Kane's daughter, and, two, trying to seduce him. I think more than a couple of papers would find that stuff worthy of a front page story.
You don't have an ounce of proof.
You sign that complaint. I'll find it.
Well, this story's too fat.
What did Anderson say about that tippy gun?
No question about it. The guy was the hood that Critter named on the air.
Great, then we can add it.
We can add nothing. He's got a rock solid alibi.
So you mean the whole thing was a great act? That's show business. Onward and upward.
Yeah. Eden, I'm going to do the intro and then I'm going to throw it over to you. You've got this story on the city council vote to increase the budget by $2 million. They've blown their chances to get reelected. Do you have any questions on that? You, Eden, do you have any questions on the story?
No.
Good. You know, I hope you're not planning anything stupid. I presume that you heard what Brent and I were talking about, but that doesn't change a thing. You and Critter still made a very good story.
A story? That's all this is to you. It's just a simple TV show. That's all it is. Just a TV show.
Don't get high and mighty with me.
You know, people turn on their sets to get information, to get the honest-to-God truth. Fine, I won't even waste my breath with you. You're not even paying attention. You don't even listen.
Stand by, please. In 5, 4, 3, 2.
Hello, this is News at Noon, and I'm Lydia Saunders. Our top story today concerns the new budget proposed by the city council. Eden Castillo's been covering that for us, and here she is with the latest. Eden.
I owe all of you in the television audience an apology. 2 days ago, I was held at gunpoint by a man that I thought I had talked into telling the truth, a man I thought I had talked out of his gun. I thought I made him understand that what he was doing was wrong. I thought I made him understand that he was withholding information to a vital case that involved the death of his friend. And I was wrong. That is what came across on the screen to you. I'm ashamed to tell you it was all a lie. In order to save his own neck, he fingered an innocent man. He lied to you, he lied to me, to all of us, and most of all, he had absolutely no remorse.
Danger even acts as an aphrodisiac with me. When Jeffrey and I first met, we were surrounded by so much danger that every word between us seemed heightened and special, and I let myself believe that I was in love with him.
You're telling me you never loved Jeffrey when you got married?
No, I did love him. When I married him, I loved him. But the adrenaline of what we had been through hadn't settled down yet. When we finally started living together as a couple, Daddy, I realized just how little we had in common.
Honey, when people love each other, they find things eventually.
But we didn't. And what does that say about the love that Jeffrey and I had?
What about TJ?
It's the same thing. I think being around TJ was so exciting for me because
It was so forbidden. You hated him, mother hated him, everybody in the family told me what a terrible mistake I was making. And all that resistance just made a relationship with TJ seem more romantic, more dangerous. Do you know, Daddy, in all my life, I have never given myself a chance to get to know a man, to evaluate a relationship to see if there's even a chance for a future. I've always just jumped right in.
You're gonna change that now, darling?
Yes, I am. But first, I want to find out who Kelly Capwell is, without a husband, without any man in her life.
Any man?
Daddy, you know what I mean. And even you. I am not gonna come running to you and Mama now. Every time I have a problem, I'm gonna solve it myself.
Oh, kitten, what am I gonna do with you? You've done a lot of thinking about this, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
I never heard you talk like this before. And I hate to see your marriage to Jeffrey ending, for his sake as well as yours, but what you're saying makes sense. If you mean it.
I do.
You have to be able to do it.
Nothing's gonna stop me, Daddy. I've already taken the first step.
What is that?
I called Jeffrey and TJ and told them that I was coming back to town and that I wanted to see them today. I've got to get them both out of my life, Daddy, once and for all.
I wouldn't think he'd have too much urgent business today.
Well, we can't be sure about that.
Well, I was kind of hoping we could spend some personal time together for a few days, maybe.
Well, we will, darling, just not during business hours.
What?
Julie, I've been away a long time. I can honestly say it's as though I've never set foot in that office. I have a lot of catching up to do.
Honey, you don't have any cases.
Well, no, not yet, but I have to prepare for the possibility and start drumming up business.
Drumming up business?
And you, I feel bad that you haven't been working either. You're entitled to your career.
Oh, don't worry about me. He's Timmons. He's at a convention.
Good. Well, I'd better be going.
Mason?
Goodbye. I won't be long.
I love you.
Same here.
It's unfortunate that the camera can lie, that what it records is actually a distorted view of the events of a day. And we benefit with higher ratings. And that's not what KSB is all about.
So, you know, if I were you, I'd really think twice about this. I mean, you do have a lot of business on the line, Phil. Your reputation, such as it is at stake. Once the truth gets out, you can kiss the whole of it goodbye.
All right, Castillo. You win this one. No complaint. But I owe you one. And I guarantee I'm going to pay it back with interest.
Your wife's on the air.
Yeah, no, she told me she was.
Did she tell you that Critter also faked us all out?
What?
So in this case, we were all taken advantage of. The authorities, as well as you, the people of Santa Barbara. No lessons were learned. This man who held a gun on me was the same as he's always been. A dangerous, misguided young man.
Who is probably looking for her as she speaks. Damn it to hell, man.
Up these ribs, or they sure hit the spot.
Yeah, I had a feeling you'd like them.
Why don't you sit down and have a couple with me?
Oh, I can't. I never have lunch. But you do understand that you have to quit calling me, don't you?
Gina, you don't know how hard it is to live in a house with somebody you don't know trying to think of refined things to say all the time.
I can just imagine. Mm-hmm. But she did buy you as Mason, didn't she?
She's trying to buy me as something, either in the bed or in the tub.
But she accepted you as Mason, didn't she? I mean, she had to.
Well, or she starts asking questions.
Well, just dance around them.
What about the wedding?
Oh, don't worry about that. It's a long way off.
You'd marry me off that skinny little thing, wouldn't you?
Think about the money. We're talking about millions and millions of dollars here. All we have to do is get the whole Capwell family to accept you as Mason. Have tunnel vision like I do. Then all you see is dollar signs at the end of the tunnel. It's great.
You sure got a way of stringing words together, girl.
Thanks.
When you start talking about money, you get this look about you that's almost holy.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Kind of puts me in the mood for dessert, you know what I mean.
Sonny, no.
Come on, girl. I'm going to need more than words for incentive if I'm going to hang around with somebody I don't know.
Well, think about the money.
Well, money ain't everything. Now, I got feelings, too. Kind of feeling that a man gets when the juices start flowing, if you know what I mean.
Well, you just go home to Julia. She'll take care of those feelings.
I want you to take care of them right now.
No, go home to Julia.
Well, just how long do you expect me to spend with this woman who's trying to climb all over me?
As long as it takes.
I think I'm going to need to have my batteries recharged before then, if you know what I mean.
No, Sonny. Sonny,
I got you now, girl.
No, as much as I'm...
Excuse me, where is Eden?
She might be in wardrobe. I think Eddie had some outfits he wanted her to try on for remotes.
It's very important that I talk to her.
Well, I'll go check wardrobe for you, Cruz. If she's there, I'll send her up.
Thank you.
You, catch the broadcast today?
Just a piece of it.
Your wife outdid herself. Frankly, I thought it was a terrible idea for her to come clean about the kid like that. In fact, I ordered her not to, but she went ahead anyway.
Yeah, well, she's always had a mind of her own.
I'm glad she does. You wouldn't believe the amount of phone calls we got after her speech. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if her little performance this afternoon didn't kick our ratings up a full point and a half.
Eden left right after the broadcast for home.
Well, let's make sure she gets back in time for the 6. I want to do a polish on her speech. The audience is bound to be huge. You know, I want Jennings to do an overnight ratings for us. We may be able to increase our advertising spot rate a full 10% the next quarter.
That's all you really give a damn about, isn't it? Ratings and advertising fees.
This is a business,
Chris. It's a business that may have put my wife's life in jeopardy. I don't expect you to care. Excuse me. Baby, you be there.
Hi, we can't come to the phone right now, but leave a message at the sound of the tone.
Anyway, I'm on my way right now, so I should be there soon. I love you. Today. I sure wish you'd told me this morning, but whatever. You should know the critter was released. He is back on the streets, and I'd appreciate it if you'd lock all the doors and windows. Anyway, I'm on my way right now, so I should be there soon. I love you.
Julia, that are you?
I don't want to talk about her now.
No, you're gonna get barbecue sauce all over your face. No, please, son, stop.
What the hell is that?
It's your secretary, you boob. Answer it.
What if she's got a case for me or something?
Well, just fake it like the rest of the lawyers in America.
The only thing I know about the law is how to break it.
You'd probably be very successful then.
Hello? Who?
Mason, glad you're here.
What?
You see Eden's newscast.
Who's?
Eden's newscast. That punk that she thought she had rehabilitated faked the whole thing. And that jerk in the DA's office let him go.
Who?
Critter. Isn't that the boy's name? He was the gang member, held the gun on Eden. Well, don't you follow what's happening to your sister?
Well, I had...
What the hell are you doing here?
I lost my earring.
Mason,
What is this all about?
Well, you heard my daddy, father. What is this all about?
Mason was just kicking me out of his office.
Then get out.
I just want you to know one thing, Mason. You can kick me out of your office, but you can't kick me out of your life. I will always be a part of your life. You hear that?
Well, that's what you think, you vile woman. Cease and desist.
What?
You have not seen the last of me.
You all right?
Yes, sir. I'm eager to hear about my sister Eden's dilemma.
Yeah, well, I want a restraining order on that punk.
Restraining order, right.
Right. I want him arrested if he's within 20 miles of Eden.
20 miles?
Anything else you can do to get him behind bars where he belongs.
Well, perhaps we could engage someone to physically disable him.
The hell are you talking about?
Break his legs. That would keep him away from Eden.
You cracking up? You making jokes with me? I don't want to hear any jokes, Mason. I don't have any time for jokes, Mason. Why don't you call up that friend of mine, Dean Farley, in the Attorney General's office? He owes me a favor. He can do something for it. Maybe he can have the whole case reviewed.
I'm glad to find the two of you here together because what I have to say applies to both of you.
Oh, what a special moment. What is this, the Kelly Capital kiss off one size fits all?
Please listen to me. Now, I am sorry if I hurt either of you, but you hurt me, too.
How the hell did we hurt you by not letting you walk all over us?
Look, we all used each other, TJ.
Yeah, and you are master degree in that, baby.
Well, I'm not denying the fact that I made mistakes.
Jeez, Kel, that's so generous.
But both of you manipulated my feelings, too.
I don't want to consider where you feel.
Shut up and let us finish, all right?
What are you going to do, let a grinder heal in your face?
Look,
that's
I'm
wrong.
Just here to tell you that I'm not going to be pushed around anymore. TJ, I don't care what you say about me. I don't care what you think about me. It's not going to make me feel guilty.
Geez, that's a big surprise.
I have never had the confidence before to go out on my own. I felt guilty because I couldn't respond to either of you the way you expected me to. Well, that is over. I was a victim, and it was my own fault. But both of you were victimizing me.
Will you hold on a second here, babe? I think you got this whole story a little bit backwards. You're looking at the two victims of this fable right here. We both fell prey to your little spoiled little rich brat act. You suck us in, you use us, you make us fall in love with you, and you throw us aside like an old shoe. And you want us to make you feel less guilty for what you did? Forget about it.
Well, I am sorry you feel that way. I hope you don't share the same feelings, Jeffrey, but even if you do, there's nothing I can do about it. I'm on my own now, and my future does not include either of you. And while you may not believe it, I wish you both much happiness.
This isn't goodbye, Kelly, whether you want it to be or not.
Jeffrey, I just tried to explain.
And I'm explaining to you. I'm not going to give you the divorce.
I had to talk to you, Eden. You're the only one who understands.
What do you mean? Kane, you hurt Andrea. How could you do something
What about me?
That?
What about me, huh? What about my heart? How many times do I have to love someone and then I lose them? First Sully, and then you?
Kane, you can't compare our friendship. You know what we have.
I know. But I loved you. You know how much I loved you. How much I wanted you. But then I found Andrea. And I thought maybe that can work.
No.
But she's the one who brought me into my life. She's the one who told me she was my daughter.
Andrea didn't know that, Kane. She didn't know.
But she went to work for the major. Even though I told her she could not trust that man, she did it anyway. She went to work for him. And what do I get, huh? What do I get? It's all lies. My whole damn life is a lie.
No, your whole life is great, Kane. It's just you need help. And Andrea, she can help you through that because she cares
about
you.
No, don't you understand? She is part of my pain. It's over. It's all over. I warned her, and she went to work anyway. I cannot forgive her for that.
Well, you have to forgive her. If you care for her, you have to forgive her.
No, I will not forgive her for anything. I won't forgive anyone. I won't forgive the major. I won't forgive Andrea. I won't forgive you. You removed, man!
You held your own with those two. You really did.
Well, I have to admit, I felt myself wavering when Jeffrey said he wouldn't give me the divorce, but I realized that he didn't mean it vindictively, that he still cares about me.
I know, honey, but you can't be pulled back into a marriage you really don't want.
I know. I'm still going to file, Daddy. I'm going to call Mason later.
I feel very bad about Jeffrey. I really do. I got to like him quite a bit, but I think in the long run he'll see this is the right thing.
I know. Hey, we'll both get a new start.
You know, I was thinking about that conversation we had this morning. How would you like to make a new start in business, too?
Daddy, I told you this is something I have to do on my own.
Daughter, I'm not talking about nepotism now. I'm talking about something to run my country club. I cannot do it. You can do it. I'm not doing you a favor. It's the other way around, and you would be completely on your own.
It does sound like something I might enjoy.
You'd be terrific at it.
Can I think about it? I'm kind of new at this independence business. I don't want to move too fast.
Look, man, we got to move fast. You're not going to stand in my way.
I'm not going to let you hurt her. Okay?
What's wrong with you, man? You didn't listen to anything she said? She's killing you off right now. She's probably filing for a divorce as we speak.
I don't care about the...
Hey! We're too deep in this stuff for you to get self-righteous now. Do you understand me? Now, right, I understand. You were married to her. She blew you off. That's tough. You're hurt. Fine. What about me? Huh? She gives me all this I love you garbage every minute. Man, I'm so sick of these rich bitches that want you to get romantic with them and then blow you off a week later.
Nah. Kelly's not like that. She's not like that.
What the hell is wrong with you? Huh? You hated her enough to get involved in this whole deal. And you hated her enough to want her dead. So don't give me this garbage or you're not going to have the spine to follow it through. You can forget about that, Chief.
Tell me something, man. Did you feel anything for her, ever?
Take a good look. This is what I care about. You understand that? And nobody is standing in my way. This is the biggest shot I've ever had, pal. And I ain't gonna miss it.
It's a little better.
You have barbecue sauce on your shoes.
Really?
Can I get you anything?
Well, when's dinner?
Soon. Did you have a difficult day at the office?
It was pretty frustrating, all those big books with numbers on them.
You mean the caseloads?
Right. I had forgotten how many of them there were, I guess. And the telephone kept ringing. It was pretty tense.
I can see that, sweetheart. Can I help you?
And then my father came by.
What did Cece want?
Oh, something about Eden being on TV.
Yeah, I heard about it. It was terrible. The guy that held it.
About this, man. I had to release somebody from prison today, from jail, who's got a beef with Eden. I guess I'm a little nervous about it.
Should have pulled the trigger. Would have solved all my problems.
Now, why the hell would I want to do that? You're my friend.
I wouldn't be so sure of that.
Kay, Kay, wait.
Go. Let him go.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Listen, I am really sorry for everything. I'm sorry I didn't tell you about Chris.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because I wanted to do something on my own. You know, I wanted it to be my decision.
What, you think I would have tried to talk you out of that? I admired you for doing that. I thought it was brave and I thought it was smart. But if you'd have just warned me, I wouldn't have let the kid back out on the streets.
Look, I'm fine. I'm fine.
So when did Kane get here?
A few minutes ago. And you know, when he's drinking, he doesn't make any sense, and...
Yeah, maybe I should go and, maybe I should go after him. Maybe I should...
No, I really don't think that's a good idea. You should just let him be.
It was a hell of a feeling to walk up to that door and hear somebody screaming at you, you know what I mean?
I'm fine. I'm gonna be okay. You know, I'm really going to be okay. We're going to be great. I mean, we're going to have a wonderful life. wonderful family. Everything we always ever dreamed of.
Sometimes. Let's sit down and tell me about this, Sherlock. I knew you were on to something.